obviously, with the new North American heavyweight champion, Mr. Unpredictable Dick Slater. And in just a few moments, the finals of the Mid-South Television Tournament will be held, of which Mr. Slater is a finalist. He'll be going against the man with the DDT, Jake the Snake Roberts, in just a few moments. But at this point in time, I think we need to address the situation surrounding this North American title. In my opinion, is a very controversial victory against Butch Reed.
Hey, I am standing here. I am a better man than Butch Reed. I've always been a better man than Butch Reed. And that is why I'm standing here for the North American Heavyweight Championship. Now, in the past, Mid-South had a ruling that if you held the North American Heavyweight Championship, you couldn't hold the television championship. Well, I made that ruling a little bit different. First of all, I demanded Grizzly Smith, I demanded that I fought my way all the way from the beginning of this television tournament to the end. I am the finalist. I will take and wrestle Jake the Snake Roberts for the television title match. I demanded the match, and I received the match, and I will wrestle Jake the Snake for the television title match.
Ladies and gentlemen, those comments...
I'll take them both. I've never been a greedy man. I'll be both the television and the North American Heavyweight Champion.
All right, I think you made your point quite clear, ladies and gentlemen. We'll have that match right after this timeout.
Jay, one fall or television time remaining for the Mid-South television title. Introducing from Tampa, weighing 238 pounds, Dick Slater. The current North American champion, also Dark Journey. Introducing from Atlanta, Georgia, the man with the DDT, Jake the Snake Roberts.
Here we are, ladies and gentlemen. It has been a long, grueling battle for these two men, but they have both reached. Slater's attacking Jake Roberts. Remember, this is the finals of the Mid-South Television Tournament. A long, grueling grind. Both these men in the final. Slater, the controversial situation, the current North American champion. Joe, this match has started off with a tremendous amount of animosity, a tremendous amount of physical confrontation. We knew it would be just exactly this way.
Slater fires Jake the Snake right out. I think Jake the Snake might have been a little bit overconfident. The ovation from that crowd was so deafening, I'm sure he couldn't hear Dick Slater sneaking up from behind on him and taking advantage. Slater will use every single dirty trick in the book to try to get ahead in his matches, as he does so often. That's why they call him Mr. Unpredictable. Slater with blatant right crosses to the forehead.
Well, Dick Slater has long been known for one of the most physical men, one of the most brutal men in professional wrestling, a man that has developed so many coup de grace type maneuvers. Dick Slater and, of course, Jake Roberts with the consummate hold, the DDT, as this capacity crowd in Tulsa, Oklahoma, they're voicing their pleasure, but Slater turning the tide, the momentum swinging back to his favor, as Jake Roberts normally controlling the tempo, Joel, but of course right now at this point in time, obviously he's definitely on the defensive.
Well, I tell you, when Slater gets on the offensive, he stays on it. He knows how to change gears and really lay into you. He's relentless. There, he's using the tights. He's so discreet, so wily, a fantastic tactician, whether you agree with it or not. The way he gets it accomplished is effective nonetheless, and he just nailed Jake the Snake on the outside of the ring. You could see Dark Journey there. As my father said last week, there's not much between your eyes and her skin. It's just about an R-rated outfit. Listen to this crowd. Go, Jake, go.
Slater with a tremendous counter maneuver. Jake was set for the, it looked like to elevate Slater, but Slater with a neck breaker. Slater has mastered, I think, every maneuver in professional wrestling. And he's got as mean a streak in him as any athlete that has ever stepped in the squared circle. He is a volatile individual, a very unpredictable man, hence the name Mr. Unpredictable.
Even in speaking with him sometimes, it seems like he'll be keeping a train of thought and then just go off on a tangent. And I think his wrestling style is kind of the same way, too. The person that he's going against can really never follow an established line of moves. They have to be waiting for anything at any time. The least expected, expected.
That's exactly right, Joel. And Slater was trying to set Jake the Snake for the pile driver. But Jake elevated Slater out of that predicament, and we've got both men. This has been such a physical match, Joel, from the outset. The finals of the Mid-South Television Championship Tournament right here before this crowd of over 9,000 people in the Tulsa Convention Center.
Oh, Slater missed it. Slater went for the atomic drop, and he missed it. I think that's the move Jake needs to turn the tide, but Jake's hurt too.
See matchmaker Bridget Smith there, the missed out official at the ring. This match so important, ladies and gentlemen, for the championship, Mid-South Television Championship, and Jake Roberts is firing back. The momentum is changing. Oh! This capacity crowd loves the man with the DDT.
He just hammered him. Listen to these people. Knee lift. Jake the Snake throws such a powerful knee lift. A Dark Journey. Dark Journey had better watch herself. She had better watch herself.
Joe, I think Jake's made a very, very severe error, a tactical error in that situation. Dark Journey obviously interfered, but he's got to keep his mind on his business in that squared circle. Slater has seized this moment and has turned the tides once again on Jake Roberts.
Again, we see that outside influence becoming a factor. Of course, Dark Journey is pretty easy to notice. Jake reverses DDT.
This crowd is going crazy. They're standing. One, two, three. We've got a new Mid-South Television Champion. A man with a DDT.
A guy with my background, a guy with my lifestyle, a guy with my habits, doesn't get a lot of shots at the National Heavyweight Championship. Now, Dick Slater, everybody knows how tough you are, and everybody knows what kind of man you are. And Journey, she does look fine. I'll let you know that right now. But see, she has nothing to do with this. You are the champion. For a short time. You see, because when you step in that ring with the Snake, well, man, nobody's going to take me out. There's a long list of fools that thought they were going to take me out. Slater, I'm coming at you. For the gold, my man, for the gold.
You know, that looks just about as good as you do. And almost better. Now let me tell you something right now. I told the people in the Mid-South area when I got here I was going to accomplish something, and now I have accomplished it all. This is the prime title holder of all times. Now a lot of good men have held this title, but a lot of good men have not put my back down on the mat for it for the 1, 2, 3. And now, Jake the Snake Roberts, the DDT I have to confront to keep this title around my waist. Well, you're not going to DDT me, Jake Roberts, and you're not going to DDT Journey, and you're not going to take this from around my baby's waist, because she's going to wait a long, long time.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next match, a one-fall or television time remaining. Introducing first in the red corner, 260 pounds from St. Petersburg, Florida, Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer. Texas, weighing 212 pounds, Steve Dahl.
Well, most certainly, ladies and gentlemen, young Steve Dahl, a rookie, 19-year-old rookie from the state of Texas, is in for the toughest test of his young career, Joel. I think I can make that statement. I think everyone would agree with me there, because the Mad Dog is exactly that. He is an animal. And we saw him last week against Perry Jackson completely annihilate that fine young athlete, and he's taking right the same stance, the same style here against young Steve Dahl.
He's rubbing Dahl's face in the mat. Power slam. or a slight version of it, I guess. A hard chop. Buzz Sawyer is so relentless, so punishing.
Very, very unusual looking boots he's got on, Joel. I don't know how to describe the footwear that Buzz Sawyer is wearing. Needless to say, that's Sawyer goes for the clothesline.
A gutsy move on Dahl's part. He went for the high risk move and he got it. But Sawyer is going to make sure and try and not let that embarrassment go unrevenged. He goes right back after Steve Dahl and continues the onslaught. He has Dahl up. Looks like he's setting for that second rope power slam. Steve Dahl is in a world of trouble.
Buzz Sawyer, he's got him, Joel. He's got him nailed. One, two, and three. He power slammed him to the second rope. That'll put anybody down. Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer.
Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer.
Let's keep it right here.
Sawyer, the winner of the match. Last week, he saw... Wait a minute. Sawyer. We saw him do this last week. He was disqualified for it against Perry Jackson. This is completely uncalled for.
Well, it's an automatic disqualification. Sawyer's going to get disqualified again, ladies and gentlemen. His actions after the match have got to be controlled. We'll be back with more. Well, wait just a second.
Sawyer looks like he's going out to the top rope. Oh, no. Oh, no. We got to get some help down here. Steve Dahl is just being manhandled. Listen to the crowd. Listen to the crowd.
Hacksaw Butch Reed is there on the scene. Wait a minute. There's Dick Murdoch.
Dick Murdoch. Dick.
Murdoch and Reed are scheduled to wrestle next, ladies and gentlemen.
Hello, all you wrestling fans in Houston, Texas. Hot stuff is happy today. You understand why? It's because I've been down to a Western store. I've been down to the store because there's going to be a big fight in Houston, Texas. There's going to be 20 men in a battle royal for $25,000. And it's a little unique and a little different because it's Buckhouse Rules. And in the Buckhouse Rules match, you wear your cowboy boots and you can wear your blue jeans. You can carry a big old belt and you can hit anybody you want to with anything you want to. Anything goes, it's going to be a fight. And believe me, Hot Stuff can figure out a way to win it, and I will.
Yeah, Houston, Texas. You know, you in Houston, Texas, everything always wild and woolly. But let me tell you, this is the match, brother, a lot of people hadn't been in. I hadn't been in too many myself. Called it a bunkhouse match. Come just like you are, brother. I'd like to come out there with a pair of program with steel spikes on them. Anything. But let me tell you, a bunkhouse match with $25,000, maybe 20 people in the match. Brother, you tell me to fight. But the one advance I got, it's too rough. So let me tell you, Houston, oh, it's going to be a night.
You know, I just came back from talking to Dickie Slater, and Dickie's on his way to come have this interview right now. But in the meantime, I figured I might as well take up the airtime. You know, Dickie Slater and myself have made a pact that we, together, united, two for one and one for two, are going to stand in our back-to-back, and we're going to win that bunkhouse brawl, and we're going to take the $25,000 and split it. And in case you people can't figure it out, that's 12-5 apiece, and then we are going to honky-tonk.
You've heard from some of the superstars.
Next scheduled match was scheduled to be Hacksaw Butch Reed against Dick Murdoch. However, if you were watching in the previous segment during a match between Buzz Sawyer and Steve Dahl, Buzz Sawyer was unrelentless. He would not quit beating on Steve Dahl even after the match was over. He was disqualified. Hacksaw Butch Reed came down to try and remedy the situation, and Dick Murdoch was right on his heels, attacked him from behind, and brainbusted him on the concrete. Let's go back and take a quick look at that if you've just joined us. Murdoch and Reed are scheduled to wrestle next, ladies and gentlemen. Murdoch's looking like he's trying to set Reed up for that brainbuster.
Wait a minute, no!
He bounced it right off the concrete. Murdoch has gone insane once again right here on the outside of the ring, and Reed is seriously hurt. Hacksaw Butch Reed, very badly injured by Dick Murdoch, being brain-busted on the concrete. We don't yet know the full extent of his injuries, but he is unable to wrestle in this match. However, we do have a substitute match. Jim?
It should be a great one, ladies and gentlemen, and obviously we'll keep you updated on the progress of Hacksaw Butch Reed. Let's go to the ring announcer, Mike Wilson.
Introducing our next match. One fall, or television time remaining. At 225 pounds, every girl's dream, Hot Stuff, Eddie Gilbert. Sir Oliver Humperdinck. And now introducing in the blue corner, from Florida, weighing 226 pounds, Tommy Wright.
Fine young athletes, ladies and gentlemen, as we prepare to continue here on Mid-South Wrestling, Jim Ross and Joe Watts with you here. And as we said, really, words can't describe our feeling right now, and our thoughts and our prayers are with Hacksaw Butch Reed as to the unprovoked attack by Dick Murdoch. But be that as it may, we do have two fine young athletes, Joel, in the ring, and one that I have said on many occasions, he has the biggest ego in professional wrestling, and I'm talking specifically about Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert.
Well, we've seen Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert go through many stages here in the Mid-South. He first came in, teamed with the Nightmare, he left him, they got back together as a tag team, they gained the Mid-South Tag Team Championships, and let me tell you, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert has got to be, next to Dr. Death, probably one of the most improved wrestlers in Mid-South. And I think one of the main reasons for that is the fact that he has learned how to implement that hot shot. What a punishing hold that is.
And we have seen him use it so effectively in the last several weeks as he has put together a very impressive winning streak. Gilbert weighed in at 225, right at 226, both men very, obviously very similar in size. Gilbert, former Pro Wrestling Rookie of the Year, a little bit more experienced, and Wright is certainly not intimidated by the laurels achieved by the Hot Stuff. Sir Oliver Humperdinck.
Well, I tell you, there are a lot of great young junior heavyweights coming into the Mid-South, where you see Sir Oliver Humperdinck. But I tell you, they're all vying for that, the Mid-South Junior World's Junior Heavyweight title that's getting ready to be established. But this man right here, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, has established himself in this territory, and he's going to be a tough man to beat. I think he's got to be one of the top candidates for that junior heavyweight title because he competes so well with the heavyweights as well, kind of like Terry Taylor in that aspect. However, Terry, of course, out of the range of the junior heavyweight contention. I don't feel like he needs to even be in it because he's definitely got to be a candidate for the North American heavyweight title, having once held it. He defeated the Nightmare soundly on Mid-South last week. Whoa, it looks like he went for that hot shot, but he didn't quite have the distance on it. And you know, that's the first time I've seen that hot shot actually put Gilbert in danger. This is kind of a new aspect to it. Gilbert caught him again. This time he sets it.
A devastating maneuver, the hot shot by Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. And Sir Oliver Humperdinck's
Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert,
arrogant young man, racks up another victory here in Mid-South Wrestling. And we'll be back, ladies and gentlemen, with Terry Taylor versus Humongous after this word from the exciting Mid-South Sports Television Network.
Get to join us later.
ladies and gentlemen, this coming Friday night, Sam Houston Coliseum.
See this man right here. He's probably one of the greatest athletes today in the world. Not only a professional wrestler, a mass superstar. And I called him long distance, asking him to come in here to help me settle one thing. The DiBiase and Dr. Death Steve Williams feud. And I'll guarantee you what, this man right here, Steve Williams, has got more credentials than you've ever thought about having.
You know, I don't have to worry about Dick Murdoch. All he wants me to do is keep you out of there, Dr. Death. You picked up a nickname by bumping heads in football. Well, you and I are going to bump heads in the ring. And this man's going to take care of you, DiBiase. No more crying, no more phone calls. When he gets you all by yourself, because, Dr. Death, you're going to be having your hands full with me. You're not going to be involved in the match. It's just going to be Ted and Murdoch.
He's internationally known, known around the world. He says he's in Mid-South for a reason. He's on a mission, but he's not going to tell anybody. Well, I know you're a mass superstar, and I know what your mission is. You're a bounty hunter. You're a man that goes to the highest bidder. You try to end people's career, break their legs, break their necks, and send them their own way. And nobody knows what that's about better than Ted DiBiase, because, yes, I've been there. But I've learned a valuable lesson, Dick Murdoch, because of you. Because when I was laying flat on my back, not knowing whether I'd ever wrestle again, because you tried to take my livelihood away from me, I found out that money's not everything, and you can't buy friends. Well, I'll tell you something, Murdoch. What goes around comes around. And, brother, yours is coming around. And, superstar, this is what you got to handle right here.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing our next match, one fall for television time remaining. Weighing 320 pounds, Humongous.
Ladies and gentlemen, here we are. What a tremendous matchup we have here for you and Mid-South Wrestling. Thank you very much for being with us. To the top athletes in professional wrestling, Humongous, 320 pounds. One of the most awesome forces in professional wrestling. A man with tremendous strength going against the sensational Terry Taylor. Joe, this should be a classic matchup.
Both men went into the collar and elbow tie-up, a very basic wrestling move. I think Terry Taylor has the disadvantage in that situation because Humongous outweighs him and is probably a little bit stronger than Taylor. But Taylor's used to that. Taylor's a specialist when it comes to being outweighed, a little bit outsized. He knows how to handle it. He's a strategist. Whoa, he meets the mask of Humongous.
Terry Taylor, very aggressive at the outset of this contest, but Humongous, once again, that mask coming in to be a very important factor. As Humongous now trying to take over and is doing so on Terry Taylor.
Well, Terry Taylor definitely has his hands full in this match. I'm sure, though, Terry Taylor, let me tell you, is a brilliant thinker in the ring. And in my opinion, one of the finest ring thinkers in the country today. However, I'm sure that he has a strategy worked out for you, Marcus.
Well, he's going to go somewhere besides the head, Joel, because that mask is there. Taylor. And Taylor went at the elbow. You know, I admire Terry Taylor wholeheartedly, but there again, you can't attack that headgear. Jake the Snake Roberts will tell you that one. It just won't work. And Humongous now, using his bulk and his strength.
You see that big leg? He went after that chin of the Maki. You can tell Taylor scouted him. He got it out of that one quick. Anyway, he goes after that mask.
I think he stuck his fingers in the eye hole, Joel. Humongous really reeling there. Looked to me like that's what they were doing.
It looks to me like Terry's fighting fire with fire. I love it. Terry is...
Oh, he's setting off those ropes. It looked like he was going for that big forearm. But I think there you're looking at the culprit.
Terry Taylor, he called it the five-bar at 9,000 strong.
comes in here from the superstation trying to be a big shot. Hey, brother, I've been to the superstation, too. I don't have to come nowhere and try to be a big shot to nobody. What I like about you, Terry Taylor, you got your name signed on the matted, on the dotted line. You got me excited, too. You got your name signed there. Signed down there. I can't even talk. I'm so happy. What's it going to be like when I take that pretty head of hair and I take them pretty little eyes of yours and I stick them down in the mat and I start rubbing them out and all the little grills are ringside. Starting on, Terry Taylor, my idol, my hero. I ain't in there to make it look pretty. I'm in there to do some harm. Come on, Terry Taylor.
Now let's hear this from Terry Taylor.
I'd like to say a very special hello to all my friends back in the Mid-South area. And yes, I'm back and I'm back home to stay. I appreciate all the cards and letters, people saying, please come back, it's just not the same. And I wasn't the same without you, and I appreciate you all sending your love and your letters. And if I ever needed your support, I'm going to against this guy, Buzz Sawyer. Everybody knows what the Mad Dog can do, but they never know what he's gonna do and when. The guy always has that unpredictable nature about him. He'll do anything to win a match. And the guy he's just like, he's crazy. He's got all the physical gifts and he is very, I tell you, he's a blessed man when it comes to his ability in wrestling, but the guy just up here, maybe it's a little bit short. So, sorry, when I go into the ring against you, I know that you're going to do anything. So I'm going to be armed with that knowledge, and I'll do exactly the same thing. The people have seen me. I've never backed down from a fight. So if you want to wrestle, we'll wrestle. If you want to fight, we'll do it all night long.
Facing the red corner, J.R. Hogg. The Nightmare. And Broadway Joe Malcolm. Gibson, Brett Sawyer, and Al Perez.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, six-man tag team action here on Mid-South Wrestling. Thank you very much for staying with us as referee Carl Fergie calls for the bell. It's going to be the Nightmare against Brett Sawyer, the younger brother of Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer. Starting out the competition here in the six-man tag action.
Well, we're starting it out with a classic matchup. Strength and size against speed and agility. I tell you, there's not many people that are gonna out quick. Brett Sawyer, his brother Buzz is one of the quickest big men I've ever seen. And Brett, I'm telling you, he's like grease lightning out there.
Right up to his feet. So very quick, and you know, Joel, the interesting thing about this situation, and I've heard this a long time, I just met Brett Sawyer recently, he's really a nice person. He's very nice to talk with, he's very personable, and it makes you stop and think, what happened to Buzz? Because, you know, he's an animal. He has no regard for anyone, and his difference in night and day. Ricky Gibson, the brother of Robert Gibson, Rock and Roll Express, and there with Broadway Joe Malcolm, and now Al Perez has been tagged in. Very impressed, Joe. The Gibson, Sawyer, Perez trio are operating very effectively here on Mid-South Wrestling.
I think what they need to do is slow it down and concentrate on that classic tag team strategy and keep that one man in the ring. You know, if you just joined us, wrestling fans, a lot of things have happened so far. Hacksaw Butch Reed was injured earlier in the hour by Dick Murdoch. We also crowned a new television champion, Jake the Snake Roberts. We'll be taking a look here in just a moment at how that match was won thanks to slow motion instant replay by SPN Productions. Ricky Gibson with a really, really hard drop kick. He just about took the head off of Broadway Joe. Hard arm whip into the corner, and man, look at this. These guys are really showing some great teamwork. J.R. Hogg into the ring now. Ricky Gibson shows him a thing or two. Welcome to the Mid-South, Mr. Hogg. Ricky Gibson is cleaning house.
Well, I must say that J.R. Hogg's one of the most grotesque individuals I've ever seen in the wrestling ring. Look at this tremendous strength. Hogg's got to weigh around 300 pounds, Joel, and Al Perez scooped him right up.
Perez is extremely powerful.
And he's another athlete, Joel, that's really improving. You can see that great improvement week to week.
Perez tried to fire him up. Perez, yeah, he connects it up. He got the flying body press. not quite as much impact as I'm sure he might have wanted to deliver in that, but nonetheless, he got it down for the lateral press. Perez, Gibson, and Sawyer are controlling their opponents quite well.
They certainly are. They are great classic tag team strategy. Quick tags, keeping their opponent in their half of the ring. Inside drop cradle, nice maneuver by Ricky Gibson. Can he get him 1-2? Hall got that shoulder up and rolls up. Hall's got a lot of bulk, Joel.
Sure does.
Big, big man.
Coming up next, we'll have Ted DiBiase in single action going up against newcomer Gustavo Mendoza. So don't go away. A lot of great action coming up. Listen to this crowd. They're getting behind Ricky Gibson. Fantastic crowd. Like you said, Jim, 9,000 plus packed to the hilt here at the Tulsa Convention Center. I'm really proud to be here to be part of the number one rated syndicated sports program in America. I love it. Oh! A nightmare with a high elevation on Ricky Gibson. He's going down. Brett Sawyer came in and touched the nightmare, but Carl Frege was distracted. And it's a good thing he was, because that might have been a disqualification. Brett Sawyer, a very, very risky move on the part of his teammates. But that's the kind of heart that Brett Sawyer has. Kind of guy that can come from the depths. He's got a lot of heart. Perez in now with those really hard, shocking rights. Forearm!
Boy, we got a Pier 6 brawl breaking out here in Tulsa. All six men in the ring. Referees have a hard time controlling this situation.
Oh, look at this! What timing! By the back!
Let's take a quick look at that DDT that made Jake the Snake Roberts the television champion.
Right here you see it. Just about to be a vertical back suplex. Jake the Snake stops it, reverses it. DDT, I love it. A new television champion. Now let's go for an exciting interview for Mid-South Wrestling Television Network. And we'll be back with Ted DiBiase in action.
Time remaining. Introducing first in the red corner from Cuba, weighing 258 pounds, Gustavo Mendoza. And introducing in the blue corner from Omaha, Nebraska, 252 pounds, Ted DiBiase.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Cuban assassin Gustavo Mendoza going against Ted DiBiase. Here on Mid-South Wrestling, Jim Ross and Joel Watts with you here, ladies and gentlemen, coming to you from the beautiful Tulsa Convention Center. 9,000 plus people here this particular time, and it's, I tell you, Mid-South Wrestling is getting so popular. The fans are finding that it's the most exciting professional wrestling that there is, and we certainly appreciate everyone's support at home and in the arenas. We certainly appreciate you. You are what make the Mid-South Sports Network click.
Ted DiBiase with a clean break off the ropes. Probably one of the greatest, if not the greatest, technical wrestler in professional wrestling today. Now, Gustavo Mendoza comes to us with high credentials. However, he's never been to the Mid-South area before. And I think if he could stick around, if he could weather the competition, then he's going to find that he'll improve quite a bit. But nonetheless, he's going up against one of the best the Mid-South has to offer, or one of the best, actually, in professional wrestling today. Many people have even ranked his wrestling ability as that above Ric Flair's. I think definitely Ted DiBiase, had he not been through the circumstances that he was recently, I think he could have taken that title for Flair.
No doubt about that. That's a great point, Joel. Ted DiBiase, there you see him. He's back in action. He's in tremendous condition. And he and Dr. Steve Williams, the current Mid-South Tag Team Champions. But you know this Mendoza, Joel, from Cuba. He's a very impressive looking athlete. He's in good condition, and I have heard from the reports that I have received, he has a very, very vicious mean streak. This man has some skills I think that we'll see in the upcoming weeks. But coming from Cuba, living in that environment and being proud of it, I think that's pretty much enough said. Coming to America, trying to make a name against American athletes, and he's in there against one of the greatest of all time, as a matter of fact, from Omaha, Nebraska, Ted DiBiase.
Jim, you're right. Gustavo does have quite a bit of potential. He's got the size, he's got the strength to be able to make it here in the Mid-South. It's just a question of how and when. You got to get out there and you got to wrestle those matches. You got to put your boots on. You got to be ready to go. Right now we're looking at a top wrist lock. Gustavo went to pull DiBiase's hair. DiBiase, no stranger to rule breaking, of course, goes back and returns the favor. Kai, he pulls Gustavo out with a big hip toss, drop kick. Well, Gustavo was knocked into that top rope, loses his balance. It goes all the way out over to the concrete floor. DiBiase poised and ready for him, though. DiBiase is always on the lookout.
You know, Joel, Mendoza pulled his hair three times. I think, you know, DiBiase was obviously, it was justified in his actions. Mendoza trying to take some shortcuts because of his experience, he realizes he's in there with the master technician.
And what a feather.
He's got to take a shortcut or two.
What a feather in his cap it would be if he could catch a fall on this great superstar. DiBiase with that foot to the side of the face. He's managing to control Mendoza. Body slam.
Joel, I understand, you know, a lot of some of the biggest names in all of wrestling coming to the Mid-South area in the upcoming weeks, and that includes one of the most dynamic tag teams in the country, the Fabs, Stan Lane and Steve Kern. I understand that we may see an appearance from them on our next program.
Yes, and if we have time today, I have a video on them that I'd like to close out the program with if we have enough time. Match, of course, for one fall or TV time remaining. Mendoza takes DiBiase into the turnbuckles. Mendoza, even though DiBiase has managed to control the match, is making a good showing for himself. He hammers DiBiase with an elbow. Russian foot sweep. He's attacking that head and neck area of DiBiase, which I'm sure is still got to be suffering from that brain busting he took on the concrete floor from Dick Murdoch. Speaking of that situation, well, here we go! Power slam! Power slam! Ted DiBiase locks up that figure four! He's got it locked up! Mendoza is being asked if he wants to give it up! Dick Murdoch came into the ring! Dick Murdoch came into the ring. Tommy Gilbert called for the bell. It's an automatic disqualification. Murdoch is hammered, DiBiase.
Fist and fire, Murdoch and DiBiase, toe to toe.
It's toe to toe.
And there's a mass superstar.
Come on, man. We got to get some help down here before something drastic happens. Dick Murdoch is in the lane spine. Come on, Ted. Show you a little bit of somebody that's coming your way, the fabulous ones. And until then, Jim, it's been a great hour.
Ladies and gentlemen, for Joel Watts, I'm Jim Ross. We'll see you next week right here on Mid-South Wrestling.
Yeah.
$5,000 the last time. Now let's get it straight. A Buckhouse Battle Royal? This has got to be dangerous. I've heard about everybody coming here, going down to Kmart, buying a pair of cowboy boots. They're going to wear those in there. Well, let me tell you something. I wear cowboy boots every day of the year, so it's nothing new to me. But I'm going to have me a surprise uniform on. And you, Paul Bush, are you Terry Taylor? Are you Steve Williams? And especially you, DiBiase, you're not stopping the redneck.
Spurs on him. I might have a big cowboy belt with a great big buckle on it. But one thing's for sure, Dick Murdoch, somewhere in them 20 people, I'm going to find you. $25,000 is a lot of money. Yeah, I've had an attitude adjustment. I've changed a little bit, but I can still be mean and nasty when I want to be. And in this kind of match, you got to be. And one other thing I got in my favor, I've got Dr. Death in my corner, and we're still a team. $25,000, a lot of money.
Okay. Buckhouse Brawl, $25,000. Come as you are. You know something? I might just dress up in my football gear and bring back old Mr. Helmet. One thing I want to tell you something, Dick Murdoch. I'm going to have my eyes on you, and I'm going to have my eyes on Ted DiBiase. I'm going to back him up 100%. And that $25,000 for two tag team partners, that's going to be very, very nice.